Now, I did send out, and you should be reading it right now, in fact, it was really your homework last night, but it didn't arrive, but to read the summary of the strategic future planning review that we did. You will get that in the mail. You will get that hopefully in the box today, so you can take it away with you and bring comments to the secretariat as you see fit. We actually had four written comments on what we were looking for when I wrote this review up, and then we had another association send one in after I finished it. So you'll get my comments on that plus that association's views afterwards. It's just ideas that you've got. We need to plan where we're going in the future, what kind of secretariat you need, what kind of communications you want. There's been various ideas. I think the main point is, and this is unanimous, and I've also had some verbal comments from some of the associations, that we must stay focused on shipmasters.
I'll try to talk a little bit about IMO, a little bit about fatigue in connection with groundings, and what we can do at the IMO to try to improve on the situation. My background material will be from the Norwegian statistics mainly, but we know that we have this same problem all over the world. But since I needed some kind of background statistics which I could rely on, I used the Norwegian. In his opening speech at the 38th session of the STCW meeting in London, the Secretary General claimed that fatigue was a major contribution factor to accident at sea and that manning was the part of the problem. I think that's a very powerful statement, and I think it's important that the IMO members do take this into consideration.
We've come here today to offer you the opportunity of having to be able to purchase an insurance, liability insurance policy to protect your interests. Not only your person, but also your assets. We've known for quite a number of years now that unfortunately marine incidents occur, and authorities now have decided for some time now, let's arrest the captain. What happens when the captain is arrested? He's left often in limbo. His ship owners, insurers, are not in a position because of their association rules to give proper assistance to the master. Unfortunately, the master sometimes languishes nicely in some jail, and until someone is in a position to come along and give him assistance.
Think about how a ship is constructed today, it's almost prefabricated. Is it beyond our technology that part of that prefabrication could be a safe unit on the ship that would actually float away without having to launch any lifeboats in the first place? And then there's the concept of free fall, which has their own problems, but nevertheless it's been handled out. It's not dangerous now to do that because we don't put people in them when we launch them. And then the one that I prefer to see, particularly on those ships such as bulkers that can sink so quickly, are the float-free lifeboats. And we seem to be, probably because they're more expensive, the owners seem to be more reluctant to go that route. As a sole, and there are a number of us that feel this way, by the way, but on our own, we had no power. So A couple of years ago, we got together as a group, and I'm talking International Chamber of Shipping, I'm talking ITF, IFSMA, the Nautical Institute was involved, I'm talking some of the cruise line ships, intertanko, intercargo. We also got the representatives of the Lifeboat Manufacturers Association involved, and the MCA in the UK. And we actually sat down and analysed the problem. And the first thing we came across was this onload release gear, which actually was introduced, rushed into our business, our industry, because of an accident that happened on a rig in the North Sea. When the lifeboat didn't reach the water and they couldn't release it, or we didn't have onload release gear.
And maritime resource management had originated from bridge resource management. That was the course that we developed in the early 1990s together with the SES airline. We soon after that realized that to just focus on the bridge, the seafarers, is not enough if we want to make a change. If we want to have a cultural change in our industry, we have to expand that target group to involve also those who are the rule makers, the power holders of our industry. And we want to get away from the no-blame culture, the criminalization of seafarers. This fits very well into those objectives. The Swedish Lobby is an insurance company, and we have many reasons for being involved in loss prevention. I'll just show you quickly a few photos to see what we do on a daily basis. Lots of examples from our claims files. Costly experiences, of course. Unexpected events for many of you as mariners, but for us, this is what we do on a daily basis.
Experience building for young officers, young dual officers who can maybe build up a bit of technical experience in the engine room, because they also get some responsibility. And that was one of the questions we had as NVVK, because we are also involved in this experiment, that we would like to have one experienced dual officer and the other one a junior officer. What they want now is two young dual officers with no experience whatsoever. And then it all comes down to the captain, when he has to decide whether the situation is safe or not. And we don't think this is a good solution. So this is a discussion that's going on at the moment. And then the advantage, of course, and I come back to the fatigue discussion this morning, a total of 3 watch certified officers, including the captain, give more possibilities to avoid fatigue, because you can split up the 24 hours and 8 hours in.
And I really want to thank you all for the fruitful discussions and the participation in the discussions, as well as the speakers who have been contributing to this meeting, so it's a very successful one. But I also want to thank Skidmore, especially Severino and Lilian, but she is not present here, for all the assistance and the hospitality we have received here in the Rio. And I hope I'm going to see you here in Rio once again, at least once again. But I will also thank the personnel, the London staff, Roberta, Roger and Paul, for all the efforts also to make this General Assembly a positive one. So thanks again, and this General Assembly here in Rio is finished. Thank you. We go through. Thank you.